discussion on intra-aortic balloon pump and IABP shock 2 trial. Intra-aortic balloon pump or intra-aortic balloon counterpulsation is used to augment the cardiac output and reduce the afterload to the left ventricle. Classic indication for IABP was cardiogenic shock. It can be either in the setting of acute myocardial infarction, cardiac surgery, or in a person undergoing high-risk percutaneous coronary intervention. The balloon is inserted through the femoral artery and the balloon positioned below the left subclavian and above the renal arteries. Aortic disease and aortic regurgitation are contraindications for balloon pump insertion. The balloon is inflated in diastole and collapses in systole. Helium is used to rapidly inflate and deflate the balloon synchronized to the cardiac cycle. Synchronization can be done using either the ECG signal or pressure transducer signal. There is a small risk of paraplegia due to injury to main thoracic intercostal vessels supplying the spinal cord. IABP is the classic condition in which diastolic pressure is higher than the systolic pressure in a pressure tracing. Cardiac monitor screenshot while on IABP. Green tracing ECG, white tracing respiration, red tracing intra-arterial blood pressure, yellow tracing pulse oximetry, displays on right side from top to bottom, heart rate, respiratory rate, blood pressure, oxygen saturation or SpO2. It can be seen that the pressure wave in systole is very small. Yellow marker is placed over the R wave in ECG. Small pressure wave just after that is systolic and the one after that diastolic augmentation by IABP. Pressure tracing and ECG while on IABP. The upper channel shows ECG and the lower channel shows the arterial pressure tracing. It can be clearly seen that the diastolic pressure after the T wave on the ECG is much higher than the systolic pressure. This is because the intra-aortic balloon is inflated in diastole and deflated in systole. Inflation of the balloon in diastole enhances the coronary perfusion. Screenshot of the IABP screen. The uppermost green tracing is the electrocardiogram, which is used to time the inflation and deflation of the balloon. The augmentation time is marked just below the tracing to indicate the exact point of inflation and deflation. The arterial pressure tracing just below that indicates the diastolic augmentation. The figure on the top in green color, 130, indicates the heart rate. The figures below that are the peak, trough and mean pressures from the arterial line. Augmentation level and alarm limit for the augmentation are the lower figures. The filling level of the helium tank is also indicated. The diagram of the graduated balloon will show the filling in real time by the flickering of light on and off. Helium is used for filling the balloon because it is the lightest inert gas which can move in and out rapidly according to the cardiac cycle. Balloon inflation and deflation can be triggered either by the ECG or by the pressure tracing. In auto mode, the choice is done by the circuitry automatically. Here the augmentation ratio is 1:1, meaning that all cycles receive augmentation. It can be reduced while weaning off, like augmentation of alternate cycles or lower. In IABP shock 2 trial, IABP did not reduce 30-day mortality compared to control. This resulted in international guideline recommendation for IABP use in cardiogenic shock complicating acute myocardial infarction to be downgraded. The trial randomized 600 patients with cardiogenic shock complicating acute myocardial infarction who were undergoing early revascularization to either IABP or control. At 12-month follow-up, 52% in the IABP group and 51% in the control group had died. There were no significant differences in reinfarction, recurrent revascularization, or stroke. Quality of life measures among the survivors also did not differ significantly between the groups. 6-year follow-up data also did not show any mortality benefit for those who were randomly assigned to receive IABP support. but mortality was very high, with 2/3 of patients with cardiogenic shock dying even with revascularization and optimal medical therapy. Routine placement of IABP for cardiogenic shock is a class 3 recommendation as per the 2017 European Society of Cardiology guidelines for ST elevation myocardial infarction.